In the beginning God made the seas, and the forest filled with trees, made the mountains up so high, and at the top he placed the sky. God's fingerprints are everywhere, just to show how much he cares. In the middle he had some fun, made a hippo that weighs a ton.
Hip, 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 hippopotamus, hip, hip, hooray, God made all of us. Hip, 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 hippopotamus, hip, hip, hooray, God made all of us. In the beginning God made the seas, and the forest filled with trees, made the mountains up so high, at the top he placed the sky. God's fingerprints are everywhere, just to show how much he cares. In the middle he had some fun, made a kangaroo that jumps a ton. Kanga, kanga, kangaroo, God made me and you. Kanga, kanga, kangaroo, God made me and you. In the beginning God made the seas, and the forest filled with trees, made the mountains up so high, at the top he placed the sky. God's fingerprints are everywhere, just to show how much he cares. In the middle he had some fun, made a manatee that plays a ton. Mana, mana, manatee, God made you and me. Mana, mana, manatee, God made you and me.
What are you working on there?
Oh, you know, just trying to come up with the best animal combo ever.
Okay, I wasn't expecting that answer.
You never are.
What combos do you have so far?
I thought you'd never ask.
Oh, no.
The Butterfant.
Oh, you have names.
Oh, yeah. The Penguin.
Aww.
The Koala.
Oh. Is that an owl and a koala?
It is.
Okay.
Yep. The Catmillion.
I don't know what to say about that one.
Well, anything to improve a cat is worth my time, because cats are the worst.
But mixing it with a lizard makes it better?
And it's more fun to look at.
Okay.
The Dubit.
Okay.
The C-Rex.
Terrifying.
Which is why Caleb Smith will not get in any body of water.
Okay.
The Labradorka.
Okay.
Dorka. The Hippopotamice.
Okay.
There's a song about that, I think, somewhere. Hip, 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 hippopotamice. No? The Orangapanda.
Wow, those are all very creative and surprisingly a good intro for today's story.
Well, that's the best news. Typically, I don't think I offer much to the start of our story time, you know?
I might tend to agree with that, but today...
I think I'm just more eye candy.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay, let's start the story.
Old Testament heroes. Job, God gives and takes away. Today's verse is Job 121b. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Job is a righteous man. He does what's right, and God has blessed him. He has 10 kids, 7,000 sheep, 3,000 camels, 500 pair of oxen, donkeys, servants, you name it, he's got it. He loves God and follows God's rules. Then suddenly we find ourselves at a meeting called by God.
In heaven?
It doesn't say, maybe. But guess who shows up at the meeting?
Abraham Lincoln?
Nope, Satan. And God says, look at Job. He respects me and does what's right. And Satan says, he only respects you because you've blessed him. take away his stuff and he'll curse you to your face. Scene change, back to Job. A bunch of bandits come and take all the oxen and donkeys. Then fire comes from the sky and burns up all the sheep. Then more bandits come and take the camels. Then a windstorm knocks down the house where his kids were, and they all die.
Oh no, what did he do?
Well, he was really sad. He ripped his robes and sat down in the dirt. But then he said, "The Lord gave me all that stuff, and he can take it away. Blessed is the name of the Lord."
That's quite an impressive response.
Yes, it is. Job was going to respect God no matter what.
Scene change. Another meeting in heaven or wherever. Satan says, "Okay, but he's still healthy. Take away his good health and then he'll curse you to your face." So back to Job, who suddenly finds himself covered with sores from head to foot. They really hurt, and Job is miserable. Job's wife comes by, takes one look at him, and says, "You should just curse God and die."
That's not a very nice thing to say to your husband. Curse God and die?
No, it wasn't. It looks like the accuser is right, that we only respect God when he gives us what we want. But Job says his wife is speaking foolishly, and he won't curse God. Then three friends show up who've heard about Job's terrible state. They sit quietly with him for 7 days. Then they start talking. "Obviously, these terrible things have happened to you because you've done something terrible. Tell us what you've done." But Job says, "I've been good. I've been following God." And the friends get a little cranky and say, "Bad things are punishment. If you want your stuff back, you need to stop being bad." And Job gets a little cranky and says, "I told you I've been good. I don't know why God let these bad things happen to me." And Job's friends get even more cranky and say, "Not only have you done terrible things, but you are proud and won't admit it. You deserve all these terrible things." And Job gets mad and says, "You are terrible friends saying I've done terrible things. God, why don't you defend me? It's not fair." And as they're arguing, a whirlwind shows up.
What's a whirlwind?
It's like a small tornado.
Oh, interesting.
And a voice comes out of the whirlwind, and the voice belongs to...
Abraham Lincoln.
What's the thing with Abraham Lincoln today?
Best president we ever had.
Sorry for the interruption.
The voice belongs to God.
Does he explain why everything bad happened? About the meetings in heaven? Or wherever?
No, he doesn't. He says, "Who's asking questions about whether I'm doing the right thing or not? Like I have no wisdom? Like I don't know about justice? I created the world. I control the seas. I rule over all of creation with wisdom that you cannot always understand. Do you know everything that's going on right now to say that I'm being unfair?"
What did Job do?
He put his hand over his mouth. He knew he had spoken of things he did not understand. He realized that God was just and wise and could be trusted, even when bad things happened. Then God turned to the so-called friends and told them they were wrong. Terrible things happening to Job did not mean Job had done terrible things. There's more going on than we can see. And God restored Job's health and gave him more kids and more camels, sheep, oxen, and donkeys than he'd ever had before. And Job kept on trusting God and being faithful to him, even when life was hard to understand.
God is the creator. He made our whole world and everything in it. Even the things that people make are made out of things God created, like your cute little animal combos.
Cute?
Yeah.
Did you see the C-Rex? It's terrifying.
Well, the point is that no one but God can create something out of nothing. God's creation is more incredible than anything we could make or think of.
I suppose that's true. After Job heard all that God had to say, he was amazed by God. He couldn't think of anything else to say to God because he was so amazed by how God created everything and cares for his creation.
It is pretty amazing when we stop to think about it.
Just so you know, I have more animal combos.
Oh, no.
The Dorse. The Dolph-a-roo.
Okay.
What about the Tig Quirl?
That name was a little harder for you to come up with, wasn't it?
Tig Quirl.
Okay.
Hilarious.
I think that's enough.
Nothing better.
It is terrifying and tiny.
For all we know, these are what people learn about in homeschool. See you next week.
Hello. Welcome to Thailand. We're taking a hot air balloon trip around the world to see some of God's amazing creations. When God made the world, He created everything, from land to water to plants and animals. Thailand is such an incredible place. It spans almost 200,000 square miles and has a lot of interesting animals. About 1/10 of every kind of animal in the world lives in Thailand. Can you believe that?
Look at those water buffaloes.
Awesome. They're called Kwai in the Thai language. In English, they're called water buffalo because they like to spend most of their time in water. It's cool that God made these huge creatures to love the water. Where do you think we are now? We're flying over a desert in India. God made all kinds of different climates, and deserts cover about 33% of land on Earth. Hey, check out those camels. God created camels with a super cool skill. They can drink about 40 gallons of water at once. They can store it up and go months without drinking for long journeys. That's how God made them able to survive in the desert. Next, we're going to someplace really cool. Literally. Whoa, check out these snow-covered peaks here in Asia. Some peaks around the world are so high and so cold that they stay covered in snow year-round. Snow leopards like to live up here. They usually live up to 18,000 feet above sea level. God created them to have very thick fur to help them survive in crazy chilly temperatures. But we don't have thick fur. Let's go to someplace warmer. Here we are in Zambia. I see some giraffes down there. God sure was creative when He made the millions of animals around the world. Did you know God had a reason for making giraffes so tall? Giraffes are the tallest land animal in the world, which helps them keep a lookout for animals like lions. We've seen some big examples of God's creations from our balloon, but you don't have to have a hot air balloon to see what God has created. Just look around you. Your friends, family, and pets are also some of God's creations. The trees, flowers, and clouds in the sky are also created by God. Everything you see around you is a reminder of God's awesome gifts. Another way to see God's big creations is to look up at night. The stars you see are trillions of miles away. God's universe is huge. But God didn't just make the big stuff. He also made a very, very small world around us that we can't even see with our eyes. If you ever get the chance, you can see all of that through an amazing tool called a microscope. This is a plant underneath a microscope. We've all seen plants before, but have you seen these little moving things? They're called microorganisms. So tiny. You can see so many amazing things under a microscope that you couldn't see with just your eyes alone. See this leaf? So much activity going on. What do you think this is? It's a snowflake. From the big giraffes to the tiny microorganisms on leaves, God created all things, big and small, to show His glory. Wow, God.
Was He not a pillar of
He wiggled up a tree. He wiggled long, he wiggled short. He wiggled back at me. Put him in a box. Don't go away, I said. But when I opened up the box, a butterfly instead. I could never make one, even if I tried. Only God in heaven can make a butterfly. Squiggly little tadpole, swimming in a lake. He squiggles right, he squiggles left, he squiggles like a snake. Put him in a jar, don't go away, I said. But when I opened up the jar, a hopping frog instead. I could never make one, even if I tried. The hopping frog was made by God, just like the butterfly.